Did you ever wondered why so many people in Africa have so many kids, even though the parents know that they won't be able to provide food for their kids and they just end up dying? Yes, neither did I. But today's episode, we're gonna find out the very reason of why people in Africa have so many kids compared to people that live in the Western world. Like, what the fuck, is this some kind of Illuminati shit? Is there a conspiracy to it? Why so many people in Africa have so many fucking kids? And why is this guy not in Transformers 3 anymore? And what am I doing in my life? And how did I manage to break my fucking flip-flops when I tried to go up these fucking stairs? And in today's video, we're gonna answer all of them questions, apart from the last three, because I made them up. So, let's get this. The first reason of why so many people in Africa have so many kids is that they got sexual needs. Yeah, and that's basically the need of having sex or sticking your dick into someone's ass, vagina, or mouth, or even your fucking ear canal, or even even your nose. But whatever, everyone's got sexual needs, even like 12-year-olds. But anyway, now you'll be wondering, if everyone got sexual needs, why is that Western families have far less kids than people or families in Africa? Yeah, that's a good question actually, and I'm gonna answer it in the next few points that you will see. But the first reason is that everyone got sexual needs, and you can't really blame Africans for having sexual needs. Like, if you're stuck in a desert for like forever, not forever, until they die or 80, what would you do? Come on, there's just desert, trees and animals. Like, you can't just be sat in a rock for like 24 hours, come on. So you have to waste your time doing something else. In the Western world, you can just go to McDonald's and get fat. But in Africa, you don't have anything to do. So instead of sitting in a rock, you just go and fuck your wife, your friend's wife, your another wife, or in exchange of goods. So you can't really blame them for having sex and whatever and whatnot. And having sex basically leads to Fendi having kids, and you can't really blame them. So now, if you move on to the second reason of why people in Africa have so many kids, is that in Africa you barely go any school, so lack of education. That's the second reason of why people in Africa have so many kids. And basically, kids, if they don't go to school and learn stuff about sex and whatnot, sex education. Like, I've been through sex education, that was like the shittiest thing to happen to me in the 21st century. It was a pile of shit, man. The teacher tried so fucking hard to explain people having sex. He fucking even used Legos, man. Fucking Legos. That show was a porn video, and that would be more nicer. But anyway, in Africa, you don't have schools. And if you don't have school, you won't learn about sex and whatnot. So people don't know anything about sex in there, in Africa. So, like, they probably think, like, the non-educated ones, which is like 60%, I'm not saying that's stupid, but they probably think that kissing people will mean that they lost their virginity. Come on. And that kissing people will make them pregnant. But you can't really blame them. We don't know any school. Come on. Like, look at this guy, man. He's fucking sat on a petrol thingy. Come on. Where are the chairs, man? Come on, you can't really blame them. They don't have schools, so they don't learn that much as we do. So that can link up to the first reason of why, you know, of why there are so many kids. And that was like, what was it? Was it sexual needs? Yeah. In the Western world, we know about sex and whatnot, so we don't have many kids as much as African people. So that can link up to that. Now, if you move on to the third reason of why people in Africa have so many kids, is just because women and girls in there are not persuaded to get a job and a career, so they just stay home and have kids and take care of them. And that kind of links up to the second reason. And that's basically the third reason, just, you know, girls and women not having any jobs or following any career, so they just stay home, have kids, and I'm sad for them. Come on. Like, having kids and seeing him dying is kind of sad. But you can't really do anything about it, man. That's the economy. The economy is booming in Africa, man. No, I'm joking, man. So, if girls and women are just sat home and not following any career or anything, we just have kids and sex over and over again. It's like, wake up, cook, take care of kids, have sex, sleep and repeat. and over and over again. So that's basically the reason. And it links up to all of the, you know, previous reasons that I said before. So not having any career jobs for girls available in Africa. And now we finally got to the last point or reason of why so many people in Africa have so many kids. And that's because, ooh, get ready for this one. I'm shaking my hands. The fourth reason is that people in Africa don't have any condoms. And if they don't have any condoms, what would you expect? They just have keep having kids over and over again. So lack of condoms in Africa, that's like the most important reason. I left it for that thing last. So if people in Africa don't have any condoms, they probably have kids. And like in the Western world, we have, you know, condoms, so no need for kids, no need anymore. But in Africa, we don't have them. No, we don't have them, they don't have them. So that's the reason, main reason of why so many people in Africa have kids. Lack of contraception, basically. So not having any condoms means more kids. And that links up to the first thingy, first reason, the sexual need. Got your sexual need, that's good enough, but if you don't have condoms, that's bad. And yeah, that's basically it. And plus, this can actually link up to the second reason. If in anywhere possible, you give some people in Africa some condoms, mainly the kids, they probably eat it. They probably eat it and die. Or they just, you know, stick it in their head and just suffocate. So I'm not being nasty or anything. Or just, that would happen, come on. If they don't go to school, they won't learn shit. They might just eat the fucking condom. So that's so sad. But anyway, now I hope that none of you that are watching this video don't start a GoFundMe page or whatever charity and in summer you get some type of aircraft, like a plane or helicopter, and just go to Africa and start dropping condoms from it. Like, you know, like them firefighter planes that drop water when a forest catches on fire. Don't fucking do that. Don't go to Africa with a helicopter, a plane, and start dropping condoms. Come on. Like, I can tell you, fucking half of the animals in there will die. They just eat it. And half of the kids in there will die as well. They just might eat it as well. So don't do that. And that won't help either. Come on, that's not. I'm not saying African kids, people are, you know, are stupid or something. I'm just saying we are not educated. And that doesn't mean we are stupid. They might be even more clever than me. Probably. But I'm not saying anything bad about African people. So I'm not racist, man. I'm multicolored. So that's the four reasons of why people in Africa have so many kids. Even though they know they won't be able to provide food for them, and they'll just die, but they just can't help them. You can't do anything about it. Unless someone like Bill Gates, like, donates, like, fucking, not invest 50 billion in Africa to boom their economy, that will happen. So you can't do anything to help them. Too bad. You can donate, but that's not helping in reducing the child problems. So so anyway, man, it's been nice of you to join me to these four reasons of why people in Africa have so many kids. You can't do anything about them, so just listen to this video and shut up. You can't do anything about it. So anyway, if you like this video in any shape or form, make sure to comment so I can read it. Maybe comment back and like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video, which should be coming out very, very soon, I guess. So till then, adios, babies.